new Red Terror. Martian mutants back from the dead.
Terraforming Mars could be a deadly mistake.
Never-ending nightmares in deep space, deep freeze. And the government sends in armed special agents to shut down an observatory. November 26th, 2018. Mars. NASA's InSight probe approaches the red planet. It touches down at Elysium Planitia. It joins a growing regiment of landers and orbiters. The data they provide will tell scientists if, when, and how the red planet can be made fit for human habitation.
There's a desire to do something very dramatic, to change the planet so that it is habitable.
The prize is massive. Literally an entire planet ready for populating.
For many, it's a plan that's not just possible, it's necessary.
Some people believe that our planet is in great danger and that someday we'll have to leave Earth.
There are a number of ideas for melting the Martian ice caps, but most of them are unrealistic, vastly expensive, or practically impossible.
Tech billionaire Elon Musk thinks that we can regenerate Mars's atmosphere by nuking the ice caps at the poles.
You'd need thousands of these weapons, probably more than we've actually built, to make a dent in something as big as the ice caps that you see on Mars.
But biologists now believe there's a much simpler and cheaper way to transform Mars. But Mars isn't going to hand itself over to human colonists without a fight. The atmosphere is 100 times thinner than Earth's. Without this heat-retaining, insulating blanket, temperatures on Mars plunge to minus 225 degrees.
It's like being at an altitude of about 20 miles and saying, okay, I'm good. No, you're not good, you're dead.
You wouldn't last much longer than 10 or 15 seconds. Your body would just become a freeze-dried carcass.
But Mars hasn't always been like this.
There are lots of observations that suggest that in the past, Mars had conditions that were right for life.
Mars may have actually had an atmosphere a lot like Earth's.
We know there are places on Mars where there were massive floods of water. You know, 1,000 times the flow of the Mississippi.
Today on Mars, this water and gas lies beneath the surface. If they were to be released, the atmosphere and landscape would fundamentally change.
We know that Mars has huge reserves of water and carbon dioxide in its polar ice caps. These could potentially be used to create an atmosphere.
Water vapor and carbon dioxide are greenhouse gases, vital elements for an atmosphere fit for humans.
The theory would be to melt the ice caps. By putting greenhouse gases back into Mars's atmosphere, it may be able to sustain itself as a warm enough planet for us to survive on.
And had them grow in a jar that had a Mars-like atmosphere.
The results are incredibly exciting and show that genetically modified organisms could breathe new life into Mars, transforming the planet's atmosphere. Not just plants, but maybe animals too.
We could send fire ants and kudzu, because those things live everywhere and you can't kill them. And I think it would terraform Mars in no time.
We could have an atmosphere and liquid oceans within a few generations. Mars might just be able to sustain human life.
We could potentially transform the red planet into another blue planet and even another green planet. That's an amazing thing to contemplate.
Imagine a time in the near future. The first colonists set foot on NASA's bioengineered planet.
You get there, and your instruments say it's okay to open your visor.
To breathe the air of a planet that you helped engineer would be literally earth-shattering, or should I say Mars-shattering.
But the explorers' enjoyment of the new Martian landscape could be very short-lived. What happens if our super-fertile, genetically modified organisms come in contact with Martian life?
If we start making Mars more hospitable to life, are we going to wake up things that have been lying dormant there for millions of years?
July 2018. The Mars Express orbiter scans the Martian ice caps. It discovers hidden beneath a lake of liquid water. And where there's water can be life.
I get really excited when we find water and oceans on other planets. Life most likely started in oceans right here on Earth. And if we find oceans on other planets, that means there's a real potential for extraterrestrial life.
Terraforming Mars could awaken dormant Martian creatures whose biology would be completely different to anything we have encountered before.
There's a sort of Pandora's box possibility here. Martian and Earth life interacting with each other, could that have disastrous consequences?
Any organism on Mars could become massive because the gravity is less than half that on Earth.
This can cause the very bodies to grow larger. These giant organisms can just live and grow.
We might be setting off a chain reaction that could spiral out of control.
Terraforming Mars risks pitting mankind against a lethal new enemy. But experts believe we have no choice but to proceed.
Do we dare play God and bring a planet back to life? I say yes. Because we're gonna need it.